Hello guys and welcome again to another NCLEX question review. Let's take a look at our question for today. Intravenous heparin therapy is prescribed for a client. While implementing this prescription, a nurse ensures that which of the following medications is available on the nursing unit? Option A, protamine sulfate. Option B, potassium chloride. Option C, aminocaproic acid. Option D, vitamin K. Take a second to ask yourself, if I am the nurse performing this procedure, why do I need any of these medications to be handy? Let's see if you can figure it out before we get to the answer. Heparin is a medication which is used as an anticoagulant. Specifically, it is used to treat and prevent deep vein thrombosis, pulmonary embolism, and arterial thromboembolism. It is also used in the treatment of heart attacks and unstable angina. Anticoagulants are commonly referred to as blood thinners. These are chemical substances that prevent or reduce coagulation of blood by prolonging the clotting time. The most common types of anticoagulants include heparin and warfarin. Many patients with a confirmed diagnosis of an existing clot are started on a regimen of IV unfractionated heparin. At low doses, unfractionated heparin inactivates several coagulation enzymes, including factors IIa or thrombin and factors Xa. At higher doses, it inactivates practically all clotting factors. The ultimate result is inhibition of fibrin formation. The physician prescribed unfractionated heparin to prevent further clots, which often develop in the presence of an existing clot. Over a long period of time, the existing clot is slowly absorbed by the body. Remember, heparin does not break down clots. Anticoagulant effects and pharmacological properties vary with the size of the molecules. The use of unfractionated heparin can be problematic because each patient's response to the drug is unpredictable, and hospital admission is often required. The biggest risk of anticoagulation therapy is an increased risk of bleeding. Another possible complication is a condition called heparin-induced thrombocytopenia, or white clot syndrome. Low molecular weight heparin is used more commonly today because of the complications involved with unfractionated heparin. In our question, we are presented with four options. Each one is an antidote to a specific condition. Protamine sulfate is the antidote for heparin. Vitamin K is the antidote for warfarin. Aminocaproic acid is the antidote for thrombolytic therapy. And potassium chloride is simply administered in cases of potassium deficit. As a strategy to approach this question, knowledge regarding the various antidotes is needed in order to answer the question. Remember, the antidote to heparin is protamine sulfate. Now that you know what each of these medications is used for, we can answer this question correctly. In this case, there is only one possible answer. If you chose option A, protamine sulfate, you chose correctly. That's it for today, guys. Make sure you subscribe to our channel for more NCLEX question reviews. If you have questions, concerns, feel free to leave it in a comment below. Thanks for watching and see you on the next one.